what a difference a few weeks makes. When I was here with the R1M, and now I'm on the beast in midwinter. Is what it feels like. It's actually not that cold. I need to man up. Get on the bike. Some people have a real issue with which side I get on the bike from. It's really weird. I don't get it. I don't know why there's a right on wrong side. I guess if you're small, it can make a difference. Oh, it bloody steams up so much, this visor. It's so annoying. I can't see shit already. So you have to open all the flaps, and now it's freezing cold. Oh, and you can't like clip it halfway. There's one little clip there. But if you can see what I'm seeing, it's not a lot. Just got a big screen on this. Maybe that's why, actually. Maybe that's why there's not enough air going into it. Jackanakanori. So I guess, what's this video? This video is really just about me trying to get back into the swing of things. I don't really record much these days. I guess this is an update video about my life. Why don't I record a lot? Because I'm inherently lazy, effectively, and I'm normally late as well, or under pressure to be somewhere, and I can't spare the time faffing around. And I'm pretty unorganised. Why don't people... Oh, she's obviously just too busy texting on Facebook to pull up to the junction properly. You may think it's easy just to put a camera on your head and start recording. And I guess it kind of is once you get into the swing of things. But you end up with a load of just dud footage of just nothing. And then you fill up your memory cards, then I come in and I'm like, oh, I'll take the camera off. And then when I want to go and record again, I'm like, oh, I've got to look through that card, I've got to copy it off. And it's like, oh, it takes too long, can't be bothered. So I need to get a regime set up that when I come into the house, I take my helmet off and there's like a USB thing there and it's automatically charging and I can drag all the data off. And then I think I'll probably record more. I know AGV gave me this helmet. I genuinely like it. Apart from, it fucking steams up so much. It's not a UK winter helmet. Pista, ironically, is actually better because the airflow on that is so good, and I do have a pin lock, which is a little, it's like double glazing, but it seems to kind of unadjust and it starts flapping around and goes all wobbly. So instead I'll just drive around holding one finger on my visor like this. I think once my head equalizes the temperature in my helmet, it'll be less apparent. But yeah, so that's why I don't really record much. I do enjoy it, but I guess I just feel a bit guilty about doing this stuff instead of doing proper work. So that's one reason. And one answer to the question, which is why don't you upload more frequently? And I'm just lazy with it. I think next year it's going to be different. I think I'm going to really give it a go. And I might even, God forbid, get a regular day to do it, like a Wednesday and a Sunday or something. Oh, Bussington. The other question I get asked a lot is, why am I always on this bike? I want to see the Gixxer, or I want to see an S1000 or a KTM. So do I. So do I. There's two reasons. One, it's pretty wintry now, thank you. And just the ultimate comfort this bike offers, particularly on a long distance like my motorway stretches. In this type of weather, it's just not worth being on a sports bike, or a naked bike in particular. That's even worse, it's even colder. And I've been really, as you may have guessed recently with the videos moaning about shit, it's been really getting to me, the travel. When I wake up in the morning now, the only respite I have is that I think, oh God, I've got to go to fucking London, oh, sit in the misery rain. and I think, oh, thank God I've got the GS, because it does make you feel a lot better about travelling in poor weather conditions. And the second reason, which is more important and more annoying, is that all the parking near my office seems to have just stopped for bikes. You just can't park anywhere. The car parks I used to park in have just said, no motorcycles, no. So what? Okay. So then you've got to try and find a space on the street, which is highly dangerous for stealing bikes. I had a Fireblade stolen there in 2010, and I've spent the last 5 fucking years dealing with the vampire insurance company who went, oh yeah, well, it's your fault, isn't it? So when it's not my fault the bike got stolen, well, yeah, it is. There's no one else to blame, is it? But, well, it's not my fault, though, is it? I didn't fucking steal it. I didn't lie and cheat and steal it. Some fucking cunt stole it at midday on a Friday afternoon on Oxford Street with disc locks and shit all over it. So it's not my fault. But anyway, so I've spent the last 5 years paying off the premium for that. There's no point in fucking insurance. I might as well have just saved up the money and just gone, oh, fuck it, the bike's been nicked, bought another one. But of course, in this stupid country, you have to have it. It's illegal not to have it, but I just don't understand why they can't offer just a basic rate of insurance, like they do in many countries, that just allows you to be on the road. If you want to protect your Ferrari or Lamborghini, fine, buy some fucking insurance. If you just drive around in a 2 grand bike, it's probably not worth paying £1,000 a year for that. You've got to work out, is the bike going to be written off every 2 years? No. So is it worth it? No. And you know, insurance companies, they're also the ones that all our pensions and all our savings and all our financial discord from 2008, it's all to do with with insurance companies. They're the ones with a massive pot of money. So they're also the ones that invest in offshore oil and fracking and all this shit that no one likes. What's going on? Wow, that's a pretty crazy manoeuvre from the ambulance. Yeah, they have a massive pot of money. That's what you do. If you've got a shitload of money, and I'm talking billions, you go, right, well, we'll set up an insurance company now because we have enough money to pay off any incidents that will occur. So insurance companies, on so many levels, are the fucking devil. God forbid you actually need their help for anything. Oh, God. So DVLA, government, please, listen. Put money back into people's pockets instead of these fucking arseholes. And just set up a system where it's the lowest possible third-party insurance that just allows you to legally drive, and that will regulate the rest of society's insurance shit. And we'll all save money and be happier. Where was I before I got into insurance? Theft. So that's another reason, the main reason why I don't ride the KTM. In fact, last night I got the KTM all ready, I put the panniers on it, put all the kind of all the stuff back from the last track day I did, I put back on it, all the road bits, and it was ready to go, and I was like, yeah, I'm gonna ride it in. And then I was like, what's the fucking point? Because I'm just gonna freak out about it. It's just gonna get, I won't be able to physically park it anywhere because I'm gonna get pushed. All the car parks are shut, and I'm not parking it on the street. No way. No way. Jose. Who is Jose? And why is he so negative? So that's why I'm on the GS. Even though, in a ridiculous way, this bike is actually probably worth more money than the KTM, it's just less... Oh, puncher, gutted. Oh, I reckon that was driving through here. Obviously misjudged, so I'm not actually gutted for you because you're a mong. You can't drive through this width regulation part. Yeah, so this bike is actually probably worth more than the KTM. But it's just less, it doesn't draw as much attention to itself. I mean, that KTM is black and orange with like vibrant colours and stickers and shit all over it, and a load of carbon fibre, and it just, people just look at it and go, I want it. Whereas this, they just look at it and go, he's this old bastard. So that's why I ride this. I'm quite liking my manual start-stop technology. Easy. My visor's steaming up. I can't see shit. Oh, I have to wait here for the fucking ambulance now. I know what we can do. Let's get some more air in my hair. Just around there. Don't stare. I know my bottom's bare. It's not fair. I actually got my KTM out of the garage. The garage. And the last time I used it was the track day with 44 Teeth and Jeremy McWilliams. If you haven't seen that, I recommend going to have a little look. And where all the flies had died, come on, fuck brain. Where all the flies had died and been just sat on the headlight, it's all gone mouldy. I've never seen that before. Like, actual white mould is growing all over the bike. I don't know why that is. Do you think maybe it's humidity? Because it has been quite warm and wet. In fact, I said it the other day, didn't I? Ideal conditions for growing mould. What a douchebag. In fact, while I mentioned 44 Teeth, I may as well do a little... I don't know what you got, how much you guys know about it, because I don't like... Well, I listen to trolls, basically, and... oh, fucking stop trying to sell this shit! So, instead of actually telling you all the other cool videos and stuff that I've been making, if you obviously follow what you like here, then you're probably going to like what I do on the other channel. So I may as well send some people there. But I've been listening, so I listen to people in the past, like, oh, fucking stop going on about that shit. I just want to clarify that it's not like, that's not a pre-existing company. Me and Al Fagan started it, and it costs me a fucking fortune every month to keep it going. But I do it because it gives me cool opportunities to do cool things. And, we pay for it. It's not like it's owned by a big publishing company. It's just two blokes doing stuff. It's not the same as like a whole corporate. I got accused of selling out because I made another channel. It's like, well, hang on, no, because I pay for it. What kind of sellout is that? I fucking pay for it. And I'm not moaning about it because we get to do some awesome shit on there. And, you know, it's elevated my status to be able to go and on bike launches, which is what I've always wanted to do. But from a manufacturer point of view, it's a bit more serious. It's not like just cocking around and swearing and, well, we do cock around and swear. But it's not like on this channel where it's a little bit more, it's a little less professional, this channel, for example. Like, it's not somewhere where Ducati or any big company would be prepared to back it in a transparent way. So you don't get the opportunity to do these things. Come on then. Better not be slow though. So to be clear, 44 Teeth is basically a motorcycle publication which I and Alistair Fagan fund. It's not something which is paid for by anyone. We don't have any adverts on the site. Nothing. And in terms of overall advertising revenue on YouTube and shit, this channel gets way more. So it's a bit of a loss leader at the moment, but we're just trying to build something cool and change the industry a bit, because it's just so fucking stale and boring, isn't it? There's no, like, there's so much clickbait going on. Like, oh, check out, oh, amazing, look at this, oh. And you go there and it's like, yeah, I've fucking seen all that before. What is that? PS de shit. MX5, you want to pick a lane, buddy? So please, it would really help me out and Al. We've done it for a year now, and I haven't really actively promoted it on this channel. I've been resisting arrest. But it would really help me out if you go and subscribe and do it, because the bigger we build that, the more chance we have of actually taking on some of the big boys and actually getting on proper budgets to do proper things with, rather than just trying to, you know, second-hand it and just, you know, gaffer tape it, which is kind of what it is at the moment. We're doing the best we can with the time and money that we have, and we've both got other jobs. Oh, jeez. So, please go over there and have a little subscribe. We're going to the NEC, Motorcycle Live, which is a big show in the UK. We're going there on Monday. Come on, mate, just do it. Fuck you. It's parking. Look how big the spot is. Wrong. What's good? Wait. This Astra is having a meltdown. What is...
Oh my god.
So yeah, so that's what I've been doing. There's a load of content on there as well, which I'm sure you'll like. So go and check it out. And what's going on? What's going on? What's going on at home? What's going on at home? Yeah, it's not great. It's not great. Pretty lonely. Pretty miserable. Pretty standard, really, I suppose. Some stupid bitch crashed into my van. £7,000 worth of damage. It's taken 3 months to get sorted out. I still haven't got it back yet, actually. What has happened? Met Royal Jordanian the other day, just down here. We didn't stop for long. We just kind of fisted each other whilst in motion. What's Geezer doing? Geezer! What's this Geezer doing? I had some other requests of, can I do an entire vlog in a commoner's accent? Well, everyone day, Gav, you know what I mean? Hey, I tell you what, it's actually quite fun dodging all the horse shit down here until you get it wrong. And you're maximum lean on some slippy manure. Oh, nice one, Merc. It's always a Mercedes, isn't it? I tell you, the vehicle I'm struggling with recently, this year in particular, it's all about the Volkswagen Passat. They just always seem to get in the way wherever you want to go. The Passat. Oh, that's the porcelain boobs. So this is the Dorchester Hotel. This is where all the, like, Arab-registered cars come. All the stupid gold-plated Lamborghinis and all that shit. This is where they all come and they all park there. So if you ever want to see disgusting vehicles, that's your place to go. Another thing I can talk about is 60 frames per second. Do you know what? I don't know if it's worth it. I don't know if it's worth it unless it's a really sunny day. This could be something to do with the camera I have, the drift. But it seems 60 frames per second in low light just goes a bit blurry. And some people say it makes them feel a bit sick. So I'm just going to go back to 30 frames per second. Because it's just easier. It's half the file size as well. Less data handling, less upload, less download for you. I did even consider, for just these types of vlogs, uploading just in a high bitrate, 720p, because it's kind of the same. Like 1080, like shit 1080p, is shit. It's all about the bit rate you encode it at, and YouTube kind of screws it up anyway. So we're all doing this high bit rate, trying to make it high res and look as good as possible, when YouTube kind of does its own thing with it anyway. So I think uploading smaller files would actually make me upload more frequently. So I think I might just do that as well. This is my channel, I can do what I want to. Maybe I'll do SVGA. GTR, what do you think of them? Yeah. Very, very fast, but I don't think I could ever consider owning one. Bottom. I can see her pants. And her wobbly buttocks. Having to deliver pizzas on a bicycle must suck the biggest penis. Okay, the nightmare begins. Well, the nightmare continues. Where the hell do we park? See, this used to be motorcycles. You could fit 30 bikes there, but they closed it. It's been closed for about a year. What is this geezer doing? Look at that. All that space for that tiny piece of shit. Nothing there. Nothing there. Something there. Oh, yes. Oh, yes, please, mister. Oh, oh. You don't know how happy this makes me feel. You just don't know. Can't possibly know how happy this makes me feel. Look how big it is as well. Oh, yeah. Wow. Amazing. So happy. Maybe today will be a good day.